Hello Libra, welcome back to my channel. I'm Aji and this is Sacred Libra, where we talk all things Libra. Welcome guys. I had an overflow of downloads and I'm still trying to figure out how to process those. I'm still learning. I'm still a student of life. I'll always be a student of life. Trying to figure out self-mastery. So bear with me, y'all. But I've just been having a lot of downloads, okay? That's a whole nother thing. So today we're going to be doing a very, very general reading. I already picked some oracle cards for you guys. I picked one from each of my decks, and you guys have a lot going on. So before we get into tarot, I see you got strength. And I feel like some of you guys have been, somebody has been making you feel like you're weak. They've been taking your kindness for weakness. They've been making you feel like you don't have any boundaries. They've been making you feel like you need them. Somebody has been making you feel like that. And I feel like you have empty well. It's time to replenish. Somebody has definitely been draining your energy. There is a situation with a person or a situation with a job that there is nothing there anymore. All your energy is drained. There's nothing fruitful. There is no sense in trying to work something out. There is no sense in trying to reconcile with the person. There is no sense in trying to make sense with this person, trying to communicate, trying to build something. It's done. It's time for you to step back, take all of your strength, and leave. I also feel like there's some type of new love coming for you guys. You do have the man holding a coin. And this could be you getting back on your goals and everything, you getting back on track. But this also could be a person that wants to help you. A person who has means to help you, who has some type of financial means to help you. This also can be a person who has some type of romantic interest. And I say that because there's a message for you also. It says, I'm thinking of you this very moment. Your love fills me with light. I love you. So I feel like for some of you guys, I'm getting the relationship feeling. Like some of you guys are in a relationship where like this person has done you dirty. I do you dirty. Like, they done you dirty, okay? They did you like white tees, and they got you dirty, like most people do with their white tees. But I feel like in this new relationship, there's going to be a lot of passion. I feel like you're going to feel free, okay? Also, I could feel like a lot of you guys could be getting back on the bandwagon. You could be doing something because you did also get the motivation card. Now it's time for you to spring into action. If there's something you've been thinking about doing, something you've been pondering about doing, now it's time to get busy and bring that thing out. So a lot of messages here. Form the oracle, okay? We're gonna go into a lot of general areas for Libra. Make sure you guys subscribe and make sure you guys like the video. If this reading resonates with you, be mindful that the readings are general, so they may not resonate with everyone. If this reading does not resonate with you, just check your other placements, okay? So let's get into it. Happy Monday. I had to really recharge, like this empty well, on point, perfect timing. So I had to really like recharge. I done took some time off from work. That may be where you guys are. I just feel like I just need to recharge my battery. Getting a lot of downloads. I've been hit with a lot of creative bursts. And while it's good, but sometimes it can hit me like a crash. What I mean. Anyway, let's get into this reading. Okay, Libra, first off the bat, you got a lot of things happening here. I feel like some of you guys, you do have some type of higher level of knowledge, but I feel like whatever type of downloads you're getting, you're afraid to move because you're overthinking it, you have anxiety, and there's another side to this thing that you've never seen. For some of you guys, you want the whole thing mapped out for you, okay? I feel like a lot of you guys could also be getting some type of wisdom from somebody, whether it's a person or spirit guides, you know, some type of intuition. Some of you guys can be meditating a lot. I feel like your mind, like you're stuck in your mind, like your head, like right now would be the time for you to meditate. It's something that you don't know the full story about, and before, you don't want to jump to conclusions out loud, like saying it out in your mouth, but you're definitely jumping to, you're definitely overthinking and dissecting the situation. Could be with the Pisces or a Taurus. You're definitely overthinking this situation, and you're getting to the ends and the out, like you are in FBI mode. That's what I'm feeling. Like you're in FBI mode. For some of you guys, you know something's going on, but somebody has not been truthful to you. Okay. There can be some type of things changing with you spiritually. Okay, you could have found something new. I feel like some of you guys could be disappointed in the way that things are changing for you, the way that something is, or somebody could be disappointed, or somebody could be watching you. I feel somebody definitely could be watching your self-improvement. Like I feel like somebody did a 360, or what should I say, a 180, a full turnaround, not a full turnaround, but somebody, you know, y'all know what I mean. We ain't gonna get into the particulars, okay? Somebody did a 180. Okay, you have people that's watching you. I feel like your vision is clear. I feel like you could be getting busy. You definitely could be starting some type of business. There definitely could be a Leo here. Definitely could be a Leo. Leo energy is very important. You can definitely work with a Leo, or you can be meditating, or some type of spiritual development. But I do see somebody has seen how much you've grown. Somebody have seen you work your way up to the top. Somebody have seen some type of somebody basically have seen you come up, and they see that you're different now. They see that the things have changed. I feel you have somebody who's watching you that feels, that sees how things have definitely changed for you. Let's see what's going on there. You have the princess, the Prince of Pentacles, the Three of Swords, and the Princess of Cups. For some of you guys, I feel like this has been a long, long, long time. There was a relationship that was a long, long, long time coming. And I feel like now that you're hurt, or you're scorned, or you're hurt from a situation, now a person is coming through trying to give you some type of offer. I've been feeling like this for a lot of you guys. It's too little, too late. I feel like also for you guys at home, some of you guys have been working on to heal some type of family drama or some type of home issue. That's definitely going to be looking up for you soon. With this Page of Cups here at the King of Swords. Some of you guys may live with an Aquarius. Or some of you guys may have taken some type of lead in a situation. You've taken the lead. You've taken some type of control over something. Okay. I feel like also some of you guys are thinking of creative ways. For some of you guys, you're spending a lot of time outside of the house. There's separation due to work, and you may be on travel, on some type of task for a long time. And you're thinking about creative ways to express your love to your loved ones, or somebody is thinking about creative ways to express their love to you. Somebody is leaving because of work and home. But I do feel like somebody is also coming, showing up a little bit too little, too late. Let's see. There's definitely an Aquarius who has interest in you, or a person in uniform, or a person who's like very structured, could seem a little bit uptight, can have like one way, like a stuck in their ways in a bit. But this definitely could be an Aquarius. I feel like somebody has some type of interest in you, but there's some type of conflict there. There's some type of competition. There's some type of drama. There's something there. This could be between you. For some reason, I feel like this is outside, but this definitely can be between you. If this person is looking at you like the Princess of Pentacles, they feel like that they know more than you when it comes to money. They could feel like that you spend your money like loosely, and they feel like that you need help with that. That's something that y'all could be arguing about as well, the way that you spend your money. and they don't necessarily agree with that. Let's look at money. Let's see what's going on with money. So there's something that you had to stand up on. There's some type of ideas about money. This definitely could be in your relationship. Some type of ideas about money that you have to defend your beliefs constantly. It could be a little chaotic at some times. I feel like some of you guys could definitely spend money fast. You can have a problem with spend money fast. Like, I feel like a lot of you guys are spending money on clothes or spending money on, like, appearance-wise. Like, you're making sure your hair is done. You're making sure your clothes look nice. You're making sure you have all of beauty products or whatever it is. Like, I feel like you spend your money on your appearance a lot. Some of you guys, you could be spending your money on your appearance, your clothes, all of those things. Some of you guys could be splurging right now, like spending money really, 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 really quick. There's somebody who doesn't like the way that you spend money on yourself. And you, like, you treat yourself. You're not unapologetic about it. Like, I mean, you're not, you're very unapologetic about it. Like, you're not trying to win nobody over. And working career, I feel like your efforts are definitely going to be recognized. You are on the right path. You probably are getting some newfound recognition. You could have had some newfound achievement. Something happened. Definitely could be working close with a Taurus or a Virgo. But I do feel like, yes, people are definitely about to start seeing how hard you've actually been at work. Some of you guys could be working with a Taurus or a Virgo. But I'm strongly feeling a lot of you guys are going at this alone. Very few of you guys could be working with people. But I feel like a lot of you guys are going at something alone. Like, a lot of you guys, this is strictly coming from within. Whatever it is that you're doing, this is strictly coming from within. This is your views. This is your perception on something. If you are working with people, like, it's all about your vision and what you want this, how you want things to go. But other people, you're going to start getting your recognition. I can see you going in the right direction. You also may have some type of travel. There could be some type of travel. I feel like if you're going to be traveling, you're definitely going to be doing some type of solo traveling in the name of business, like going somewhere by yourself. Okay, let's see. So there's a situation that you're overthinking right now. But some type of judgment is going to go in your favor. You just remember the times when you got the short end of the stick. That could be coming up for you. The judgment is going to go in your favor. This is a time for you to be happy. Like, you've been sowing your seeds. You've been planting your garden and it's fruitful. Now is the time for you to be stable. You got the Queen of Pentacles. This is the Queen of Stability. You have made yourself stable. Look around. It's time for you to rest. Rest in your green grasses. Rest in the things that God has laid out for you. It's time for you to rest, and it's time for you to look around and be happy. Be in the present moment. Understand that you have a lot to be blessed with, and get out of your mind. Okay, you got the Nine of Swords here. So a lot of you guys are truly in your mind. Like, truly, like, in your mind, overthinking about a situation that's going to go in your favor anyway. Let's clarify these cards, though, for you. Libra, we got a lot. We working with a lot over here. Let's see. What messages do we have for Libra? If this reading is resonating with you, make sure you give this reading a big thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. Right, let's see what we got for you guys here. Yeah. Definitely some type of breakup. Okay, so you have the ten of swords with the two of cups in reverse and the seven of cups. Okay, somebody definitely fed you so many lies in a relationship, and you're just done with that type of energy. That's why you have this. Like, I feel like for some of you guys, like, you knew what was going on, but you knew there was another piece of the puzzle that you didn't quite really know a lot on, so you didn't want to jump to a conclusion. Something definitely does come out here. There's a breakup, there's an argument where something comes out where you realize that a person has been feeding you every single lie in the book. This definitely could be big Pisces energy here. Or Taurus also. And I feel like this person has you drained. I feel like this is what this is here. This strength card and this empty will. Like, somebody has took your kindness for weakness, and there's nothing left there. The well is empty. There is nothing left for you to give a person. Like, for some of you guys, this is done. Like, beyond done. Like, there is nothing. You have nothing else to give a person at all. At all. It is time for you to put your big boy or your big girl panties on. Pull them things up. Replenish yourself. And keep on moving and understand that you're stronger than you actually think you are. Some of you guys could really, really be feeling drained. Like, somebody fed you every single... Like, had you believe in a whole illusion. Somebody had you believe in a whole illusion. And it was a lie. It was a lie. And what's bad about it, I seen this. They said, I forgot it. But it's in my Libra group that I do follow. It was saying, like, Libra already knows, like, when a person does a Libra wrong, and this is basically what the cards are, Libra already knows, but they be mad that the shit actually came true. You already knew there was something going on. Like, you already knew there was something going on. You have some type of higher learning, some type of higher knowledge about this, but you did not jump. You didn't want to jump to conclusions yet because you know you overthink. I say, like, Libras overthink a lot, but most of the times we be right. A lot of the times we be right. So if you think that's your problem, like, I need to stop. Like, no, that may be how you process, how you weigh things out. I feel like we're blessed with that. We're blessed with the option to weigh things out. And sometimes it may hurt. Libra to Libra, it may hurt that our minds do that. And we can't stop it because if we don't know, we can't be left in the gray area. That's the one place. We can't really be left there. We have to weigh something out so we can make a decision. And I feel like some of you guys knew, and what hurt you the most is that thing that you had that gut feeling about, you were right. It wasn't all in your head. Somebody was actually feeding you an illusion. And that's one of the things also, Libras hate when people play on their intelligence. Like, just don't play with my intelligence, man. If I'm coming at you with all this stuff, don't call me crazy if you're actually doing it. If you're doing it, don't call me crazy. What else do we have? You got the Eight of Swords again. So I feel like some of you guys, there's something changing here. So this was some type of disappointed news. So you did get some type of disappointed news that changed. It was some type of ball game that changed a lot of you guys. This is a relationship. But now your eye is back on the prize. I feel like some of you guys are getting back out there, especially with this Eight of Swords, this Ten of Cups, and this Six of Wands here. You're getting back out there. You were stuck, but now you're going back to find your happiness. I feel like something definitely happens. This could be a new love or something. Something definitely happens that gives you a rush and puts you back into the spotlight. Like, you may even have to have a pep talk, like, be like, you know what? I'm a bad bitch, okay? Whatever you got to say to yourself, whatever your affirmations are, like, you probably had to say all your affirmations and everything to boost yourself back up, because somebody really had you drained. Strength card. Somebody really took your kindness for weakness. Somebody really hurt you to your core, had you feeling weak, okay? And you had to reboost yourself up. You had to rebuild yourself, regain your confidence. Now other people are seeing you. Now other people are seeing all that hard work. It's a lot of hard work to get from the Eight of Swords to the Ten of Cups. That's a lot of hard work. So you guys should be happy about the hard work. I said this in the last video. You guys should be happy about the hard work that you've done on your confidence. Like, you've really boosted your confidence up. Boosted yourself up, okay? This could also be your health. You could be doing something like working out, eating better, taking care of you. Like, you have gotten out of that place of being stuck by fear, being stuck by the past, by the things that you don't have control over, and you turned that shit around. You turned it around. Some of you guys had to fake it to make it. Some of you guys were feeling like this, and you had to wear big smiles because the ball had to keep rolling. Like, you had things to do. You couldn't sit back and cry. Like, some people have the luxury of sitting down and crying. The other people, they have to suck that shit up because money needs to be made. Like, you got kids, you got family, you have a life. Like, things got to keep. You can't afford to sit out. Okay, but I feel like a lot of you guys have boosted your confidence, boosted yourself back up. Okay. All right. So you have the Devil, the Queen of Wands, and the Ten of Pentacles. For some of you guys, it was a long time coming for you to heal your heart, and then here comes somebody coming again. This is what I'm feeling strongly for this. Here it is. You already boosted yourself up. People are starting to recognize you. Now you're fully in the spotlight, and here comes this manipulative MF-er. Okay. I'm trying to be good today. Here comes this manipulative person who, like, the sex is probably crazy because it's a lot of fire here. This is probably one of the, this is somebody who is very manipulative. There's a lot of strong passion and fire between the both of you, but the relationship is not good. Okay. Somebody wants to create something with you. I feel like if you've left a person, you left somebody who was definitely cheating on you, who you realized they were telling you a whole bunch of lies, they're definitely coming back, and they're coming back saying that they want to give you something. Somebody wants you all to themselves. Somebody sees how good you're looking now. Somebody sees how much you worked on yourself, how much you got yourself back together, and they want that. They want that. They want it with you, but they want it if they can play this position, if they can be the one who controls, if they can be the puppet master, if they could be the one who tells you what to think and when to talk. You know, they want you believing everything that you tell them. And in the past, you've seen that that didn't work. You also could be making money now. This person definitely could be making money now. They can see that you're happy at home if you have kids. Like, they can see that, like, okay, dang, I left this person and they're still keeping the house up. They're still keeping themselves up. The kids look good. Everything, everybody's flourishing. I want a piece of that. Beware. Got the King of Wands. Could be a Leo. A Leo or a Capricorn. Beware. Please beware. Let's see. Let's see what we got in romance. So we did have this Aquarius person who is passionate about you, but it does bring some type of gossip happens here. You have the Chariot with the Three of Cups and the Ace of Swords. I feel like some of you guys are definitely going to be moving on. Some of you guys are definitely going to be moving on with the person. There's something about your friendship groups that you find. There's some type of conversation that you have with a friend. Or you can know this person with a... Or this person could be a friend. This person could also be somebody that you work with. But I do feel like there's other people, there's a lot of competition around this person. This person may have a lot of options here. This person may have a lot of options, and I feel like just from your last relationship, you don't really want that. Like, you're being disciplined. Like, I feel like y'all are attracted to each other. Y'all have chemistry, but you're disciplining yourself and moving on. There could also be a lot of people trying to get this person's attention at this time. I feel like there are people that are planning. Somebody is plotting and somebody is planning here. Somebody is plotting something. Somebody is planning. It could be them. For your money situation, I feel like right now you're feeling very stable. You're working on some type of craft. And like, you're in the spotlight. Like, you're controlling this thing. So what if you spend, like right now, I was seeing that you guys were spending money fast on yourself, spending money fast on you, like looking good on clothes and everything, but you're also making money fast as well. Just be mindful though. Make sure that it's not like cutting into anything. Make sure you're making great decisions. A lot of people are not going to like the way you're spending. Also, a lot of people may have a problem with how much money, how fast you're making money, and they just probably don't understand it. They're probably used to the regular 9 to 5 punching, but I do feel like entrepreneurship, especially with this magician card and especially with this Eight of Pentacles here, I feel like some of you guys could also be buying a new house. And somebody has something to say. You're gonna constantly have to tell somebody, like, this is my money. You can't tell me how to spend my own money. Somebody wants to tell you how to spend your own money. You got the Page of Pentacles. I feel like some of you guys could have some type of blocked intuition. You could have had some type of blocked intuition, some type of writer's block, lack of motivation, needing to connect with your inner feelings. A lot of this could have been from a breakup, but then you get back on the ball rolling with this King of Wands. You get back. The King of Wands is all about hard work and dedication. They have to work themselves up to something. Like, they understand that they have to hustle to get it. You get back on it and things definitely change. Like I said, some of you guys definitely will be traveling. There's definitely going to be some recognition. You definitely are on the right path, but there's some type of solo travel. There's some type of solo travel coming for you guys. Let's see. And what else do we have for my Libras? Double judgment. Double judgment. Like, you guys are literally in your head. Take a deep cleansing breath and release all of the fuck shit. Just release all of the things that you're overthinking. This is definitely a time to be happy. You have been planting your seeds. You've been busy at work. You've been planting the seeds. Okay, this is a time for you to sit back and relax. Also, you have this too. You got the Hermit. You definitely have all the answers inside. You've got some type of clarity. You have all the answers. There's no need for you to ponder and overthink. Like, you're just overthinking yourself out of it. But for real, in action, you have all the answers. And whatever it is you've been waiting for is coming. It is yours. And you're content with this Nine of Pentacles. I thought this was the Seven of Pentacles at first, but with the Nine of Pentacles, like, I feel like since I've seen the Seven of Pentacles, you've been waiting on something and now you're going to be secure. There's a sense of security and stability coming towards you. So if you're not independent, it's definitely coming. It's definitely coming, okay? There is a lot of negative energy, a lot of drain energy here. There's definitely a lot of drain energy. There's a little bit of you know, not paying attention. Of course, some of you guys could definitely be going through a breakup right now. You can be at any stage. This is just very general, okay? But there's definitely something that you don't see that's right in front of you. I feel like at least you guys are trusting your intuition. At least you guys are not being moved by outside forces. And if you are, you definitely need to dig within. But I've seen the Hermit too many times to know that some of you guys are going within. Like, you're not trusting outside opinions. So at least you're trusting yourself with that. You have not given up on love, but rest is definitely needed. Once you rest and restore yourself, this is what's behind that. Oh, now I got to show y'all. This and this. I love when the Empress and the Emperor comes out. This is perfect balance to me. Once you rest and replenish, you restore to your natural self. You restore to who you are. Just make sure you're not giving something to an empty well. Make sure you're not watering an empty well. Make sure you're not planting seeds where the grass, there's no type of fertilization in the grass. The grass isn't fertile. Make sure you're not planting seeds there. But once you rest and repair, once you rest and recover, you replenish yourself, you back. You're back to you. You're back loving. You're back growing. Everything you touch does turn. Okay? You're back with this big Empress energy. You're back sitting back, confident, feminine, letting things come to you. Letting things come, letting all of your blessings and your desire attract to you naturally. Okay? You're not in a place where you're overworking yourself. All right. So Libra, that's the message that I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed this message. If you did, make sure you give me a big thumbs up and make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel. I love you guys and I will see you in the next video.